You're watching Chilly Boy Productions. I'm Larry Chilly Boy Chilson, and this is my review for West Side Story. Now, before we get into this review, make sure to go ahead and click that subscribe button down below so that you can chill with me on each and every one of my latest videos. West Side Story is a 2021 musical drama directed by Steven Spielberg that is obviously an adaptation of the old Hollywood classic. In a divided New York, a young Puerto Rican girl falls for a white boy, but they soon find out that making their forbidden love last is more difficult than they'd hoped for. And ultimately, it leads to an all-out war between the two sides as they fight for ultimate control over their turf. So yes, I have seen West Side Story, the original. And it definitely hasn't aged very well at all, actually. And it's never been one that I've like loved and lauded as one of my favorite films, certainly. But with all of those racially outdated lines and themes and, well, castings that took place with the original classic, I felt that maybe this was a good film to remake, to update, to right the wrongs of Hollywood's past. Plus, I love Steven Spielberg. As cliche as it sounds, yeah, he's my favorite director. Even those not great mid-level films that he's been churning out over the past decade, I usually actually quite enjoy them. So I went in, trusting Spielberg himself and excited to see my Latina and Latino brothers and sisters represented on the big screen in this big film event. And ultimately, I left highly disappointed. Thoroughly unimpressed. This is the film y'all are pushing for Best Picture? This is the musical we're championing for all them Oscars? Where? Because I didn't watch the same film y'all seem to. But before we get into all that, let's go ahead and talk about what the film gets right first. Well, I need to start with Steven Spielberg himself because his direction is actually really fantastic when it comes to West Side Story. The camera work and cinematography is all stunning. And the way that Spielberg blends the new technology with the homage and ode to old Hollywood cinema is beautiful. I actually thought the high stylization of the film was stunning. And most of our leading cast members deliver wonderful performances. Rachel Zegler is our new Maria, and she is a delight. Her acting was lovely. She really brought this earnestness to Maria, but honestly, it was her voice that shined. Oh, what a stunning singing voice she has. Of course, our legend, Miss Rita Moreno, returns for this remake, and I was so pleasantly surprised to see how much she's able to just shine through in this film. They give her some great stuff, and she is more than up for that challenge. She was fantastic. David Alvarez was also wonderful. I thought his dancing skills, amazing. But also, he was really able to bring Bernardo to life. But at the end of the day, it is definitely Ariana DeBois who steals the show. She is the standout, the revelation of West Side Story. Once again, Anita steals the spotlight from Maria because, yeah, we all know that happened in the OG film as well. But Ariana is the perfect all-around package. The dancing was amazing. The singing was fantastic. And then her acting performance, nobody could touch her. What a star. And this was her big breakout. And speaking on the musical productions, all of the dancing sequences are a lot of fun. They're really well choreographed as well as beautifully shot. It makes such a difference getting a big musical like this when we have actual dancers who can execute some great choreography, these big numbers that look fantastic from everyone performing them. We have actual people who can sing and deliver these performances, because that is a little bit of what's been missing in recent memory with musicals. We don't have great singers and dancers, and, well, it's shown. So then, what didn't work so well when it came to West Side Story? Well, honestly, I can sum up the film in a single word: antiquated, old-fashioned, out of date. Everything about this film just felt unnecessary. And that is a word we throw around a lot when it comes to remakes and sequels. It 100% applies here, because, yeah, they updated the story a tad. We changed a lyric here and there, and oh, yeah, we cast an actual Latina in the lead role, though not Puerto Rican. Still, she's Latina, but the racist undertones and stereotypes are all still there without adding anything important to say. So what's the point? The musical numbers themselves feel old school Hollywood. Everything about this film felt like the original, the era of the original, a very, very old-fashioned, outdated style of making a musical. And while I was watching, I thought, yeah, that's right. This is why I've long said I don't really enjoy musicals. Not to mention that score I thought was actually horrible. It really ruined any sort of tone that was being set, particularly when we weren't in the musical numbers. It just felt out of place in most areas, and it was highly overbearing. I really did not like the score. And the story is just as outdated as the racial undertones that are present. I mean, we've already been new. This is Romeo and Juliet, the Latin flavor edition. And we don't need that anymore. We don't need that again and again. If you're not going to do anything interesting with it, why are we telling it? And Maria in this film comes off looking horrible, a complete and total fool. Even Disney has moved on past the love at first sight, instantly falling head over heels for a guy trope. And actually, when they do put a love interest into their film, they make fun of that trope every chance they get. Yet, here we are, presenting it one more time in a horrible fashion. We've got overacting. We've got this old school dancing. I didn't really enjoy it. I don't understand. And yeah, that lead male, he's there. His voice sounded all right, but want to talk about overacting. Hardly justified his own existence in the film itself. But the allegations came out after all of the filming was done. So we're just going to move along. So overall, I was just thoroughly unimpressed with West Side Story. I'm seeing 96% on Rotten Tomatoes. I'm seeing people's best film of the year. I'm seeing best picture lock at this point. All of these awards coming up. What movie did you all watch? I don't understand. I'm truly baffled. And moving forward, if you're going to call films unneeded, unnecessary, if you're going to harp on Disney for what they're doing with their remakes, well, keep that same energy for this, because put this side by side with the original. Yeah, it might be a slight improvement, but you'll see it's not needed. And in my book, unwanted. So if you're a fan of the original West Side Story, if it's an annual rewatch or something for you, then yeah, go watch this. You'll probably love it. If you like old school musicals, you also will probably enjoy this. However, if you're like me and you never really enjoyed musicals, I don't think this is your cup of tea at all. In recent years, we've kind of done some new exciting things with the genre of the musical. We've had some really great ones come out that are pushing us forward. Even one this year that, yes, had an Afro-Latino problem, but overall had much more positive Latinx messages in it that I thought pushed the genre way ahead. But West Side Story was right here to remind me, this is why you've not been a big fan of the genre for so long. So that's it. That's my review for West Side Story. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, go ahead, click like down below, and subscribe to the channel so you are always up to date on all of my latest videos. Also, join in on the discussion. What did you think of West Side Story? Let me know either in the comments down below, or you can hit me up on Twitter. I love you all so much for your continued support. Mwah! Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye!